Good afternoon, all. This is Sarat Kumar from Infinity PMC Solutions. I'm hosting this webinar. Ms. Janani is the speaker for this webinar. Thanks for being patient. Janani, we can start the session.
Thank you, Sharad. Good afternoon, everyone. Hope my screen is visible. So today's webinar topic is quantifying construction MEP quantities using I2COSTEX. So this webinar is hosted by Mr. Sharad Kumar. He is as a manager for business development, and myself, presenter for this webinar, Janani, serving as manager for professional services with Infinity PMC Solution. So agenda of today's webinar. So first point, we are going to see how COSTEX is suitable for plumbing, electrical, and HVAC quantity takeoff. Second, how workflows can be set up for our accurate quantities, counts, and quantification, which is including our takeoff. Third is about on-screen takeoff method for measuring our conduits, cables, and duct length. Next is about when we are receiving our revision files, how we are going to do our revision management in I2COSTEX. So then finally, we are going to see how IPMCS is supportable for I2COSTEX. So we are Infinity PMC Solutions Private Limited. We are a project and cost management solution provider with a combined experience of 20 years in the construction industry. So we have handled 100 plus batches of trainings for corporates and institutions. We have handled projects in EPC, infrastructure, and construction sectors. We are in partnership with Oracle, RIB, and F&D. This slide explains about our solutions and services. For planning and scheduling, we provide a planning and scheduling solution using Oracle Primavera product, EliquoSoft Power Project, linear project management using TurboChart, and visualization using Schedule Reader. And when it comes to estimation and 5D BIM, we provide a quantity takeoff and estimation solution using RIB I2COSTEX, which also extends up to 5D BIM. When it comes to risk management, we provide a risk management solution using Palisade at Risk, Power Project, and Oracle Risk products. For 4D BIM, we provide a project management solution using EliquoSoft Power Project, where you can integrate your BIM models and project schedule with EliquoSoft Power Project for achieving 4D BIM for your projects. And finally, when it comes to other services, our other services include product and project implementation, support, for technical and functional, and we also extend our services and scheduler services and staff augmentation on contract basis. So we are an authorized Indian partner with RIB for I2COSTEX, Oracle Primavera for Power Project with F&D, Schedule Reader, TurboChart, and At Risk for ArcGIS with SRET. So first, we are going to see about how I2COSTEX will be helpful and what are the benefits of using I2COSTEX for an MEP project. So we all know about the MEP elements, which covers the mechanical, electrical, plumbing, and HVAC elements. So now today we are going to see in this session how all the four drawings can be used for a quantity takeoff for a single project in I2COSTEX. So I2COSTEX is a product of RIB, which is a complete 2D and 3D BIM estimating solution. Our solution I2COSTEX is a digital estimating software with universal application. You can also call it as an all-in-one single integrated platform to work for our project estimation. So as you can see here, it supports both 2D and 3D models for your project quantity takeoff. Yeah. COSTEX is compatible with other solution and tools also. First, when we speak about drawing, COSTEX supports 2D files like AutoCAD, PDF, and JPEG files for quantity takeoff. And when we speak about IFC or BIM models, it supports models from Revit, ARCHICAD, Tekla, MicroStation, NavisWorks, etc. So once our model or drawing is imported, we have a dimension view module preparing our quantity takeoff. We have a rate library module for preparing our rates, project rates. And with the workbook view, we can prepare our cost plans, BOQs, and estimates. And once a cost plan is prepared, we can also generate a report, which again can be exported to PDF, RTF, image files, etc. So Costix is a solution which helps an MEP QS person to be more productive and smart compared to the traditional method. So how? So if you are going to use your 2D drawing, so you can measure your cables, conduits, ducts, and you can count your fixtures, fittings and fixtures in just a few clicks. So this is how you can be more productive and smart, because it uses an on-screen takeoff methodology for our quantity takeoff, where your quantity will be highlighted on your screen in the drawing. So there will be no chance of missing an element in your quantity takeoff. So that way you can be more smarter in your quantity calculation. Benefits of using IT Costix. First, when it comes to measurement, you can save your quantity takeoff time with the automation and live link workbook. Next is about auto revisioning feature, which is a unique revision tool to identify your changes, and it also helps you to update your quantities. And it also has a separate report writer where you can prepare professional, standard, and customizable reports for your project. The next feature is about estimating workbooks, where you have an integrated workbook, a spreadsheet-based workbook, so where you can maintain your accuracy so that you can have you can achieve a greater certainty of outcomes. And you can also achieve a paperless estimating, as the entire transaction will be your paperless, where you can receive your drawings through mail and you can do your on-screen estimation. And finally, you can collaborate with your team, as Costix has a network capability, so where multiple person can work on a same project at the same time. So in this way, you can also save your time in working for your project. So first we'll say about accurate quantification of MEP fixtures. I mean, how counting of fittings and fixtures will happen in I2 Costix. So here we have an option. If your drawing is more accurate, you can count using an automatic option to count your fittings and fixtures, or you also have an auto count option. So let me show how it works. Say, let me take an electrical drawing, so where I'm going to count for the sockets. I'm going to count for 6 amp socket. So you can just use an automatic option, so that using a shortcut, you can count your 88 number of sockets from this entire drawing has been counted automatically. So this is one way of counting your MEP elements. And let me take a firefighting drawing.
Sorry, one second, explain to me. Sorry for that thing.
Here I'm going to count my sprinklers. Already I have counted some of the elements, like other types of sprinklers, which is a ceiling sprinkler. Now I'm going to count my side sprinkler. So I'll just go move to my drawing and just zoom any one of the sprinkler. Using a shortcut, I'll count the entire sprinkler in the drawing. You can see totally we have 44 numbers of side sprinklers in the drawing. So this is how you can use an automatic option. And if you want to count your, let me say, we have a reducer here. So if you want to count these elements, say I cannot use this shortcut. So now in that case, you have an option where you can just go to layers. You can just invert it. And I'm going to count it by capturing it as an image. So here I have an auto count option. I'll capture this image of one. And I'll search in my entire drawing, so that it gives me accurate countings of how many elements I have in my entire drawing. So these are the easiest way to count your fittings and fixtures. Where these are difficult when we are working with our traditional methods. So it's getting counter. So now you can see wherever I have that symbol, it's been highlighted in my entire drawing. So now once you have cross-checked with your drawing, you can just give save accepted. You can clearly notice how many number of elements we have. This way you can easily count your elements. Moving back to our presentation. So I have counted some other elements like VCD, volume control damper from the drawing. You can see here. This way you can count your entire elements like valves. So let me take, if I have a schematic drawing here. So if I want to count my valves, butterfly valves from my schematic drawing, then it becomes very easy. Here's my complete schematic drawing. I'll just use an automatic method. You can see from our entire list, you can see the external valves. So you can count for your entire drawing here using this automatic shortcuts. Okay, you can see totally we have 1,246 numbers from our entire drawing. So this is as much easy to count your entire number of elements from the drawing. So moving back to our presentation, next to our countings, you're going to see how this same on-screen takeoff method is helpful for measuring your conduits, wires, and ducts. So again, we are going to see with the drawing. In addition to this, we are also going to see how we can use our customized formulas for our quantity takeoff and how we can include our coefficients. Coefficients in the sense, say if you are going to measure a duct, each and every duct with different guards will have a different unit weight. So how you are going to apply your unit weights for your different types of guards and for ducts. So that is what we are going to see in this. So let me take a duct drawing. So here I have measured a duct. You can see. So if I just select any one of the duct, I can see what is the gauge, surface area of the duct with the diameter and duct weight. So while before calculating this, I'll use this template for giving the inputs. So here, while giving these inputs, I'll mention the diameter. And in addition to this, I'll use the customized formulas for calculating my surface area and duct weight. So when you want to calculate your duct weight, obviously you need your kg per square meter, which is the unit weight for your ducts. So that can be saved here under. You have a constants feature. So where you can save your duct weight for different gauges of different thickness. So you can see. So this is how you can save your project coefficient. So for this is not a project specific. You can save it one time for all your MEP ducts, different types of ducts and gauges. And you can use it for your other projects also. So now I'm going to measure another duct. Say this duct is of 22 mm gauge. So now I'm going to measure another duct. Say this duct is going to be a different gauge, right? I can just change here easily. So this is of 24 mm. By changing this, we can make your duct weight also to be get automatically updated. So this is how you can measure your duct. And by using this on-screen takeoff method, you can clearly see what are the ducts you have measured and what is being left out. The same way when you are using a electrical drawing for your conduit measurements or wire measurements, wire quantity takeoff, you can again clearly see what are the conduits you have measured and what is being left out. So this is what the advantage of using estimation tool, which applies on-screen takeoff method for your quantity takeoff. So you can easily measure again, say if you just click on this particular way, it will be reflecting a small piece of length, that's all. So, but you can use some shortcuts to measure your entire stretch of conduits. So this is how, again, you can use your shortcut for measuring your length also. So this applies even for your conduits, ducts, wires, and what are the elements you're going to measure lengthwise. The same way, if you want to measure pipes with your plumbing layout, again, you can measure it diameter wise. Say have, if I want to measure 20-50 mm diameter drain pipe, right? So I'll just go to drawings. I'll select the drain pipe layer inward. You can see, we can easily measure. The same way, if you want to measure some other types of drains, right? You can just select your layer and it will be highlighted here. So what are the pipelines you have measured and what has been left out that can be easily identified. The same way, when you want to measure different pipes, right? Say like drain pipes, refrigerant pipes, water pipes, soil pipe, waste pipe. So that can be highlighted using layers. You can just make that particular pipes alone to be visible in your drawing and you can go on easily measuring. And even if you want to add a reducer or a T or elbow, you can easily add it under custom quantities. Say here, if when I'm measuring the 100 mm refrigerant pipe, I know the vertical drop and the total length for that pipe should include the vertical drop. So here I have customized the formula and I have added the vertical drop which will be highlighted in the drawing. So when I'm selecting a particular refrigerant, say from here it's running and here I should provide a vertical drop. So now when I'm selecting this particular length, so the total length including the vertical drop is 10.06 meter and the horizontal length alone is 9.26 meter. So this is how you can customize your quantity takeoff. And even when you want to add your reducers, you can just customize your formula for adding your reducers also. Just if you want to add it for 12 meter length one reducer or 10 meter length one. So that's how you can customize your formulas. And next is about collaborating your quantity takeoff and estimate with the drawing. Say I have taken a quantity with the electrical drawing, firefighting drawing and plumbing drawing. So now finally, when I want to merge all these quantities into my estimate, which is a spreadsheet-based workbook in Caustex, so here it is possible with the integrated workbook, which is hierarchically maintained. So you have three different types of sheet. One is your cost sheet, quantity sheet, and your rate sheet, where you can maintain, include your rate analysis and quantity breakdowns also. And advantage here is you can maintain a live link of your quantity and rate in your estimate. So your quantity will be linked with your 2D drawing and your rates will be linked with your rate file. So you can maintain a rate analysis, I mean, your built up rate library also in Caustex. So let us see how it is working. So again, moving to Caustex here, and this I am maintaining three different workbooks and finally I'm going to integrate it with one workbook, which is an MEP estimate. So now when I want to update a quantity in the electrical workbook, so you can see here, so I have updated the main, you can see quantities are updated here. So now when I want to update the 6 amp quantity, right, so here again I can just drag and drop. So that is how quantity takeoff is maintained. And the main advantage is you can maintain a live link with your workbook and your drawing. So live link in the sense, say I have counted 88 number of 6 amp sockets. So if I want to go back to the drawing and to review how many, from which drawing I have taken this quantity, you have a show source option where you can just go back to your drawing easily and you can easily identify where are the quantities and from which rooms or from which drawing you have taken those. So this is what the live link. And again, I'm maintaining three different workbooks. So finally, you can prepare one workbook where you can collaborate multiple, I mean, all the other line items here just by linking. So let us see, I have an internal electrical works which is coming around 36478. So when it has been updated, right? So it will automatically reflect in my MEP workbook where I have combined all the four estimates together. And even when you want to combine, when you want to collaborate all your MEP works again with your civil and architecture works, right? Here you have a merge option. You can finally, when all the people in a project has completed the working, say like civil person has completed his work with BOQ, architecture again with the BOQ, MEP person with the BOQ, you can collaborate entire person, all the three or four people's working together in a single project by using the merge option. So this is how collaboration works here with your drawings and estimate in I2 Caustics. And when you want to maintain rate analysis, so here let me just say supply and fixing of ball valve for cold water supply of 20 mm diameter. You can maintain your rate analysis with supply and fixing. I mean, your material charges and your labor charges. So this is how you can maintain your rate analysis. And this entire process, which starts from your quantity takeoff until your estimate preparation, can be used as a template for your second projects. So that is another added advantage, which will reduce your time for the next project. So that is how you can achieve more productivity with your further projects. Moving back to the presentation. So next we are going to see how revision logs are going to be maintained, how we are going to manage our revision changes. So here here we can prepare our revision log. We can start from revision number 1, 2, 3, like that you can continue our revisions. And once you have created your revision log, you can add your revised drawing. And once you have added your revised drawing, you can compare with your older to your newer drawing to see what is the changes with the older and to the newer. Once you have an idea of, after the comparison, you can update your quantities automatically.
Janani,
so let us, hello?
Your yes, screen Sharad. Is not a shared, I think. Okay. It's not visible.
Okay, let me share again. Is it visible now, Sharad?
Yes, Janani. Thank you. Yeah.
Okay. So you can compare your drawings. Like you can overlay one older drawing to the newer drawing. So you can see in this picture, you are seeing a blue line, red line, and the green one. So green one indicates your newly added elements. Red one indicates your deleted elements compared to the older one, and the blue ones indicates your lines or the elements which remains unchanged with both the drawings. So this is how you can compare your drawing for your quantity takeoff. So once your quantity takeoff is done with the updated drawing, we can also maintain a revision log. So where you can clearly see what are the elements that have been revised, how many counts, what are the lengths that are being changed. And you can even generate your variance estimate report with your previous quantity and present quantity, previous total and your present total, and variance in total and quantity. So let us see how this revision works. So to manage your revision here, you can use your revisions option. I'm going to add a revision and just naming it as R01. So now from out of this entire drawing, so let me say this fire sprinkler layout has been updated with a new file. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to update with a new drawing. So I'll choose a new drawing file. So I'll choose R01 layout. Update. So once you have updated your new layout, you can see clearly here the quantities which we have taken from the older layout will be made as zero. So you'll get an idea easily what are the quantities that we have taken from that particular drawing. So before entering into your quantity takeoff, as I told earlier, you can compare your drawing. So I'm just going to compare my drawing with the older drawing, so which gives me clear idea about what is the changes. So here, we are not finding any major changes. So minor changes is, you can see clearly here, we had a pipe here which has been changed, the position has been changed. And here again, you can see the sprinkler has been deleted and this pipe has been, pipe position has been changed. And here again, you can see some of the sprinklers has been deleted. So this is how you can identify your changes. So deleted ones and the new position or the newly added elements. So once you have identified your changes, I'm going to measure the fire water line. So I'm just selecting, you can clearly see what are the invalid elements. Invalid elements indicates, say from this position, your pipe position has been aligned to the new one. So this is how you can identify your invalid and valid elements. Say these pipes doesn't have any changes. So it makes you to identify clearly what are the deleted elements and what are the newly added elements. So you have an option to delete all your invalid, and you can make your, or you can customize your new quantification. Or you can use some shortcuts also to include your quantities. So you can update your quantities. And next, your reducers. So after seeing from your entire drawing, you can accept your quantity. Then again, I have a side sprinkler. You can see side sprinkler. So these, this sprinkler has been deleted, right? So delete your quantity and to update with the new ones. You can see this is in green and this is in yellow. Yellow ones are the deleted elements. You can just easily delete your elements and you can accept your new quantities. In that same way, here again, two of the sprinklers are being deleted. The others remains unchanged. You can delete your invalid. That's it. So, so your quantification becomes more easier when you are updating with your revised drawing. So once you have updated with your drawing, you have a revision log where you can see your dated one. Say we have made changes to three quantities. One is your fire water line, side sprinkler and the ceiling sprinkler calculation. And what are the changes you have made? You can see here clearly. Side sprinkler from 44, it's been changed to 43, and sprinkler count from 13 to 11. So with this, you can just go and update with your estimate also. And I have updated here, means you can just promote your workbook, which will reflect in your entire estimate. And you can also generate a variance report with your quantity updation. So if you have multiple workbooks and multiple elements, right, you can just easily go and update with your promote workbook often. So this is how revision works. So here you can manage your revisions continuously. Right now we have seen only R01. You can go up to R02, R03, R04. Like that, you can continue for your revision logs. For each and every revisions, your initial workings will also be saved as a log. So this is about your revision feature. Moving back to our slide. Next is about why IPMCS for I2 Costex. So we are an authorized Indian partner with RIB for I2 Costex. We have handled 100 plus trainings and we are also into implementation of templates. And we have our certified consultants for I2 Costex and we provide support to our existing clients and we resolve their query within 4 working hours. So that's why. I2 Costex, IPMCS is preferred. And services offered by IPMCS for I2 Costex, we provide I2 Costex fundamentals training with PULI and I2 Costex advanced training with BIM. And we also provide a product-based training, I2 Costex 2D and I2 Costex with BIM. And we also provide a role-based training separately for quantity surveyors, for estimators, contractors, or senior management. And when it comes to estimation QS services, we offer pre-construction and post-construction estimation services and staff augmentation. Related to staff augmentation, we do recruit QS or billing engineers, project coordinators, planning and scheduling engineers, and we deploy at client site. Clients of I2 Costex. So there are multiple clients who are as cost consultants, contractors, quantity surveyors, or real estate developers. Some of the clients are GMR, Soban, Arth Design, Neo, Invicara, ST Corp, K Raheja, Intech Infra, Gleeds, Maze, Acom, Turner and Townsend. So these are just some of the I2Costex testimonials from our clients Turner and Townsend, GMR, and Arcadis. We IPMCS and RAB for I2Costex, we provide post-sales support also. Functional support as a value-added service based on client requirement. Some of the functional supports, like we help you out for your project coefficients. You can creating a library with your project coefficients. Just for example, we saw in this webinar, we can use our duct weight. There are different unit weights as per the gauge thickness. So those kind of weights can be taken here into I2Costex and can be created as a library. And we also help in how method of measurement can be implemented in I2Costex. And if you want to include your project specification, so here we can all again help you out for preparing a phraseology library for building your BOQ descriptions. And we also suggest best practice method for quantity takeoff and for preparing your estimates. Thank you, participants. Once again, we are Infinity PMC Solutions Private Limited. You can reach us at info@ipmcs.in. And if you have any queries, you can post in your chat box or you can unmute and ask your queries.